Hello. Welcome to StudentLearning.in, your e-learning buddy. Welcome back to our channel, guys. If you are new to this channel, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon to join the family.
Today, I'm going to explain Hive commands in Big Data. Hive is a very important aspect of Big Data in terms of Hive commands. Hive commands are divided into two parts. First is DDL command and second one is DML command. DDL command means data definition language. This command is basically responsible for all the structure of database or table. Second one is DML command. That means this command is basically responsible for content of the table. DDL command are the statement used for defining and changing the structure of a table or database in Hive architecture. It is basically used to build or modify the table and other object in the database. There are a lot of Hive commands in terms of DML. That means there is a create command, show command, describe command, use command, drop command, alter command, and truncate command. In case of create command can be applied both the table and database. Show command can be applied databases, table, table properties, partition, functions, and index. Describe command apply on database, table, and view. Use command apply only database. Drop command can be applied database or table. Alter command can be applied database or table. And truncate command can be applied on table. So first command is create command. With the help of this command, we can create a database or a schema. So there is a very simple syntax. Create table and name of the schema. If not exists very much, define the database name. Commit database comment, create database or schema. If not exists, then define the database name. Comment means if you want to write anything about the database, that means you can write in the comment section. Locations means is the SDFS file with database properties. Properties means property name and properties values. Property is nothing but it's a key value pair. That means it is basically used to mention the properties. Like for example, this is a case to create database. That is very simple. Create database. If not exists, then that is very simple. Test DB. Test DB is a name of database. Then mention the comment. Comment is very simple. I want to create a database for employee. That means we have to mention database for EMP or employee. With mention some DB properties. That means I want to mention date, creator or email ID of the creator. That means you can mention date is equal to 2020 28 9 month, creator is a student, and email like info@studentlearning.in. or we can use this command, it's very simple manner, just write create database and database name. Next command is show command. With the help of this command, we can display all the database in the Hive. So just we can write show and mention particular database or schema. That means name of the database or name of the schemas. Next command is describe command. Describe command is basically used to show the name of the database. Describe statement or describe command is basically used to show the name of database in the Hive and also show the location of the system. There is a very simple scenario. Just write describe database or schema. Then there is an optional command that is called extended. It's optional. Then mention the DB name. Next command is use database in Hive. The use command in Hive is used to select the specific database for a session on which all subsequent Hive QL statement would be executed. So this is a very important command in case of database. So in this case, we can simple use, just write use and name of the database. Next command is drop database in Hive. Drop database statement is basically used to drop database in a particular group or particular databases. That means if you want to delete any database in databases, then we can apply drop database. The syntax is very simple. Just write drop the name of the database or schema. If exists, after that mention the database name with their two options. First is restrict and second one is cascade. Next, alter database. This is a very important part in terms of DDL command. So alter database statement is used to change the metadata association with the database in file. There is a very simple command. Just write alter and name of the schema or database. Then mention database underscore name set DB property. That means you have to mention some DB property name and property values. There is one more syntax in case of changing the database owner. That is very simple. Just write alter name of the database or name of the schema, database name, set owner. There is an optional user slash role, user or role. That means with the help of this command, we can change the owner of database very easily. Next command is a create table command. So create table is again a very important command in Hive. Create table in Hive is basically used to create a table with given name. If table or view is already exists with the same name, then it shows the error. So in this scenario, we can use if not exists to escape the error. So there is a simple syntax, just write create table. There is an optional syntax, if not exists, then mention the DB name, then mention the table name, column name. Column name, suppose there is a column name is name, then you have to mention column name. Data type, suppose your data type is string, that means you have to mention a string. Comment, if you have any comment, then please mention comment like this column belongs to this and that. Similarly, we can add multiple columns in a single table. And after that, just use store as file format or location as JFS file. Both the options are optional. This is an example of create table in Hive. Suppose in this scenario, there is a table and table name is employee and the column is employee ID. Employee ID is a string and comment is a simple comment. This is the employee ID. Employee name is a string and comment is a, this is the employee name. Next is employee designation, employee salary. Employee salary with data type begint and comment is this is employee salary. Row format and field terminated and stored at text file. That means this table is used as a text file. Next command is show table command in Hive. With the help of this command, we can show or we can view all the table in current database. For this, we can simply write show tables and within a big bracket, name of the database. Next is describe table command. Describe command is basically used to display the structure of a table. We can simply write for this describe. There is a two optional syntax, extended and formatted. Mention the DB name, table name, column name with field name. With the help of this command, we can describe the structure of particular table in Hive database. There is an example. Suppose the table name is EMP, then we can see the column name is EMP ID, EMP name, EMP designation, EMP salary, and the data type is string, 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 and this is a comment. Comment is this is a employee ID, this is a employee name, this is a employee post, this is a employee salary. So with the help of describe command, we can show all the structure of table. Structure of table means like all the columns names, column values, data types, and comments. Next command is a drop table command. Drop table command is basically used to delete a particular table in a Hive metastore. We use purge option when we are absolutely sure to delete the data of a table. If purge is not specified, then the data is actually moved to the trash. If purge is specified, that means data is lost completely. So there is a simple syntax, just write drop table. There is an optional one, if exists, then mention the table name and purge. There is one another important command in case of table, like alter table. With the help of this command, we can change and we can modify the structure of the table in Hive. That means you can add any columns, you can remove any columns, you can change the properties, you can change the data type of the tables. Syntax is very simple. Just write alter table, table name. Suppose you want to rename the table with new name. So just write alter table name, rename to new table name. Next, suppose we want to add column in a table. So just write alter table, table name, add column name with data type 1 and data type 2. It's up to you. You want to add multiple columns, then simply write alter table, table name, add column 1, add column 2 with data types. Next is very simple syntax in case of alter. Suppose to set the properties of a table. That means we simply write alter table, table name, set table properties. That means you have to mention property keys and property values. Property value means new values of the property. We can see in this example, there is an alter table, there is a table name, TBL properties, table for IT employees. So with the help of this command, we can alter the table in terms of table name, in terms of table data type, in terms of adding a column, in terms of dropping a column. Next is a truncate command. Truncate is a very important command. Truncate is applied on the tables. If you want to remove all the rows from the table, that means we have to write truncate table and table name. With the help of this command, you can remove all the rows in the table. Next command is DML command. In case of Hive, DML command are used to insert, update, retrieve and delete from the Hive table once the table and database schema has been defined using Hive DDL command. That means with the help of DML command, we can change the content of table. So there is lot of DML command in case of Hive. First one is load command, second one is select command, third one is insert command, fourth one delete command, fifth one update command, sixth one export command, seventh one is import command. So in case of load command in Hive is used to move data file into locations corresponding to Hive tables. If a local keyword is specified, that means load command will look for the file path in the local file system. If the local keyword is not specified, that means Hive will need the absolute URL of the file. In case of keyword override, that means the content of target table or partition will be deleted and replaced by the file referred by the file path. If override keyword is not specified, that means that is very simple. That means the file referred by file path and will be appended to the tables. And there is a simple syntax in case of load command. Just write load data, and there is a optional syntax, it's called local. Then in path, file name, there is an override option into table, table name, partition, partition column 1 equal to value 1, partition column 2 equal to value 2. This is a simple example. Suppose we want to try to load a data from dev file into the local file system to the EMP data. So this is a very similar syntax. Just write load data local in path, and we have to mention the path. Path is like home, data flyer, DAB is the file name, into the table emp.data. Next command is select command. With the help of select command, we can retrieve data from the database. So in this scenario, we have to mention select column list from table name. Suppose we want to retrieve first four columns of the table, and the first four column name is name, age, salary, designations and ID. So just write select name, comma age, comma salary, comma ID, comma designation from EMP. Insert command. With the help of insert command, we can insert Hive tables or partitions. There is a multiple syntax of insert command. The first one is insert into. The insert into command is basically used to append the data into existing table. That means your table is already created in the Hive database. So it's a very simple syntax. Just write insert into table name, partition, partition column 1 equal to value 1, partition column 2 equal to value 2. And after that, just mention from table name, that is from statements. Next part of insert, that is insert override. Insert override table override the existing data into a table or partition. That means the override command is a very simple syntax. Just write insert override table, table name, again mention partition and column 1 and value 1. If not exist, then simply select a statement from the statement. That means suppose table name is EMP, then simply write select EMP from insert override command. Is basically used to insert override table, override the existing data in the table or partition. This is a simple command, or this is a simple syntax. Insert override table, table name, partition, partition column 1 and value is equal to 1. And mention select statement from the statement. Next is insert values. With the help of this command, you can insert data into table. It is very similar to SQL. So we can just write insert into table name and mention partition column name 1 to value 1, column name 2 to value 2, and enter multiple values in the use of keyword values and values row, values up to values 1, values 2 and values 3. Delete command. Delete command is basically used to delete the table in the database. Delete command is basically support to asset property. as it means like atomicity, consistency, isolation, and durability. It's a very basic syntax. Just write delete from table name, and there is a condition with where expression. Suppose I want to delete some rows, simply write delete from EMP where city is equal to Delhi. So that means delete all the records whose city is Delhi. Next is update command. Update command is also support to asset properties. With the help of update command, you can change or you can update the content of table. There is a very, very simple syntax. Just write update table name, set column name is equal to value and with expression. Suppose I want to change the city to Delhi to Mumbai in database EMP. In this case, just write update table name, that means update EMP, city is equal to Delhi, where city is equal to Mumbai. Next is export command. The export command export the table or partition data along with the metadata to the specified output location in the HDFS. That means HDFS means Hadoop Distributed File System. This is a simple command. Just write export table, table name, partition, partition column, and values. Here is an example. We are exporting the student table to the HDFS directory. That means export from Hive. So just write export table student to export from Hive. That means HDFS directory is export from Hive and table name is student. Next is import command. The Hive import command import the data from specific location to a new table or already existing table. For this, there is a simple syntax. Just write import table new or original table name, partition, partition column, and values from the source path. In this example, we are importing the data exported in the above example into a new Hive table, and table is imported table. So just write imported table, the table name from, there's a location, user default, export from Hive. It's a simple command.
Thank you so much for watching. Please leave your questions in the comment section down below. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe to Student Learning. Check out more courses from us and follow us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, basically everywhere. The link is always in the description. We will be back with more lectures. Stay tuned and have a good day. Bye.